So you've returned. Do you still remember?
We've got more stuff to do, and by that I mean we got a whole nother side quest and plot. Plenty of plot. Good fair amount of plot. As soon as I spread this link around. I should set, like, so. What if there's a bot I can set up to, like, automatically tweet. Well, there's definitely a tweet out bot, because that's included with Streamlabs OBS, but I wonder if there's, like, a bot I can set up for Tumblr. Anyways.
Oh!
I'm so sorry. Are you alright?
No. Excuse me. Tis but a scratch. Don't worry about... No!
Oh, no, please. Here, come and sit down.
It doesn't look like anything's broken, but I suggest you take it easy for a while.
Well, that won't do. I just got in a rush order, too.
A rush order?
Yes, from an expedition that set out for Grap Keep a few days ago. They say they need additional foodstuffs delivered at once.
Food, huh? Okay, we're on it. We can deliver it for you. You said it was a group headed for Grap Keep, right? Is there an addressee?
It was, yes. They call themselves the Ominous Party.
Okay, what? Did you say ominous?
That's right. They should be easy to recognize, what with that pet Dagon they had with them. Not to mention the bodyguard they hired. An odd-looking one, but quite the archer. I believe her name was Artemia.
Right. Artemia too.
Idia, I understand why you might be uncomfortable, but we did offer. Let's just go and get it over with.
Right. Okay. So we just need to take the food you've got there?
Yes, that you do for now. The party said they'd be ordering more, so I'd appreciate it if you could ask what else they need.
Sure, will do.
Thanks a lot. You're doing me a true favor.
I don't recognize that voice actor offhand, but I recognize them, but I don't know their name. I just know that, like, I recognize them from ye old classic 4Kids voices. Forget who they were in what show, but they. No, was that Mike Pollock? It might have been Mike Pollock. It was Grump Keep. This was just a location for some of the poison samples in the first game. This is fairly minor compared to, fairly minor. Oh, I forgot to heal. Fairly minor compared to... Dark Fort. Probably go heal, or at least just like. I seem to recall this place being overall less complex than, No, I'll leave and heal. I don't wanna. Hello. Let's see here. I don't really remember, like, I didn't remember Starkfort that well either, but there were parts of it that I remembered at least, but Grapkeep is very irrelevant in the grand scheme of things, since in the first game you only had to go to it once. With Starkfort, at least you have to go there every loop if you want to do all the side quests. So I don't really remember the full scope of this place's layout, or how many floors it had. Lancer Hunter Knight, meaning just... Heat should be enough. I don't have enough BP for 4 side wonders. Come on. More Peeg. Wait, there was an adventure right there. There. So if there's an adventure right here, does that mean... Not like officially. Like, I don't think we're in a quarantine area, but we did get classes off for the next week. We are expected to return eventually, though. We're not in the close to the season mode yet. Here. Should probably save it for a heal, just while I get the obligatory grinding done. On the knight, and then just sidewander the hunter. At the moment, I'm mostly just streaming. I don't know if it's safe to get my mind off things, because I'm not super, like, stressed about it. But it is something to pass the time. You know, actually... If I wasn't so concerned about money, I'd just buy a bunch of Phoenix Downs. Because, admittedly, the ability to do this... is pretty valuable. Still though, I do need money for the to fill out the shops. Prefer to get that done before throwing the money away so willy-nilly. Damn, okay, these guys are kind of hardy. bark, bark. Well, I guess the fox just doesn't really bark.
Good. I'm stuffed.
Magnolia, you've really become an amazing chef.
Tell me about it. I really look forward to the days when you're on kitchen duty.
Vaimon? You're too kind. Now, wait right there while I get dessert.
Dessert, too? This is a treat. Ow, 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 ow!
What's wrong, you?
My muscles. Oh, they're cramping up. Ow!
You remember, don't you, Magnolia? His little problem?
Don't talk about it like that.
Oh, wee! You're terrified of ghosts! A real scaredy cat!
Well, hey, but they're the only thing I'm scared of, remember?
Yeah, your only fear. You've been hunched over in terror since we got here. Your muscles are bound to feel the strain.
But Idia, you don't like ghosts either. You said so.
Who does? But they don't make me completely lock up in terror like you. Anyway, I think I'm going to get some fresh air.
Wait, where are you going?
It's...
just getting in a little exercise. Gotta make room for dessert.
What fresh air can you get in a friggin' fort like this?
I really admire her commitment. To dessert, I mean. Indeed, braving these pitch black corridors and narrow stairs, with evil spirits lurking around every corner. So, what's the story with this keep anyway?
Well, it all goes back to...
Was that Idia? What's she doing? Idia? Are you all right out there?
Yep, I was just taking some practice swings and, hit the wall by mistake.
That must have been some swing if we heard it all the way in here.
Did you hear that? It sounded like small bits of debris coming down from the ceiling.
You know, these walls are really fragile. I mean, I barely touched this one. I think we should just knock through the walls instead of following the passageways.
I don't think that's practical. They're way too thick for that.
She probably just knocked some plaster off the surface, that's all. In any case, Idia, please stop hitting the walls!
Huh? What's this about walls? Oh, she's amazing! Oh, you really topped yourself this time.
Really? Merci beaucoup!
Hey, how did he...
2 seconds before it was ready, she just appeared next to me, spoon in hand.
Like... a ghost?
Woo.
You know, I'm still hearing a lot of falling debris.
Did you taste this, everyone? This is to die for.
So either she punched through the wall, or Idia was a ghost the whole time. I'm not sure which idea is scarier. Right. I just do double key heat. That's fine. The zombies, like the skulls and the bone guys and the other zombie knights seem to be the only things here, so I'm not too concerned about having to grind so much for completion. Zombie knight, which will take a bit. Zombie samurai is outside, I think. And so the Bone Knights are already done. Bone Lancer needs some work. Bone Hunter needs some work. Okay. doors open.
The door is open.
I don't even know what that was supposed to be. It's like... I really should watch Zenfagira, but I've heard so many good things about it, but I just don't, like... I don't know. I have a hard time just watching anything new. Same thing with, like, Castlevania Netflix. I've heard such good things about that, but, like... I don't know. Right now, I just kind of want to rewatch Love Live for the 50th time, except this time I'm trying to get one of my college friends to watch it with me. Damn, these guys are fucking party. Okay, so if I go in this way, is that door open? Yeah, okay. Wait, the door's been open the whole time. Wow, I have no critical thinking skills for this place, but, so I think one of my guys got poisoned. I guess not. Unless it was Magnolia who has the auto cure, I think. Well, I think it's Magnolia that has the auto cure. Does help get some of the zombie knights out of the way, but this is not exactly how I want to do it. That noise never gets less annoying. Power bracers. What? Huh. Do you have, like, flame? I have no idea what happened. Power bracers. That is... increase of strength. So, I believe it should... Well, can I... I kind of appreciate the crit up on you. And blind... immunity blind on you. Sure. So... Let's take another look at the bestiary. Dumb zombie knights. Dumb with bone hunters. Need exactly one more bone lancer. Okay. Should be everything. Okay. So now let's just finish exploring and get to the good stuff. I remember what it is I need to do. Remember what exactly? No, I remember what I need to, but I don't remember exactly where the hidden passageway to get over there is. It's probably on one of the edges somewhere. Go back up this way. Okay, I might need to go like to the bottom here where the adventurer is. Okay, here we go. Hidden passageway to get a cross spear. Oh boy. I guess it would matter if I was using spears. And it's another weapon to throw. Rest of the cottage. And onward we go. Plot. And by plot, I mean side plot.
We've found it at last. With this, the ultimate magic is...
Ominous Crow, partner to Bahamut and holder of the Black Mage Asterisk. Formerly a lieutenant commander of the Eternian Sky Knights. He bears an enduring grudge against women. His explosive personality wins him few friends among his comrades. But none would deny his skill with fire magic. By what strange trick of fate do your paths cross anew?
Ding dong! Delivery for Ominous Crow! Good grief, you'd better be grateful for this.
An earthquake! It's a big one!
Where is everyone? You? Magnolia? Tiz? Oh no, the stairs!
Yeah.
Even my muscles are no match for this.
You know, I think most people would realize that without even trying.
Tiz, you're all right!
No good, sir. There's no sign of an exit on this side either.
You! And Magnolia! Oh, what a relief.
I wouldn't get too relieved. It would seem we're trapped.
Trapped? What about the others?
They're fine. Ominous and his party are resting just over there.
I see. Well, first things first. Let's deliver the food we brought.
About that, Idia. We were thinking it might be better to keep quiet about the food for now.
I have to agree, sir. We split up to search for a way out, but there was none to be found.
We can hope the townspeople will send a rescue party, but that won't happen until they realize we've gone missing. We may want to hold on to that extra food until we really need it.
Ominous and Bahamut aren't likely to be that patient. Not to mention Artemia.
Yeah, and while we're at it, let's not tell Ironwood about what what Jin said.
A secret for now. Come on, you. Help me hide it.
Let's see. Let's just get all the map done because I'm a little bit anal about that.
Ominous, unfair. Not fit for leadership. Artemia, not follow.
Music. Venus, the wild sweet music.
Holder of the Ranger Asterisk. Youngest of the Venus Sisters. And formerly of the Bloodrose Legion, with whom Idia and her allies did battle. Be not fooled by her cuddly appearance. For this soft exterior hides a fierce heart that sings most keenly when battling to the death. By what strange trick of fate do your paths cross anew?
What did you say? Why, you impertinent little...
Food should be shared. Equal. Fair.
Why should I have to share my food with a hired help? Don't you worry, Bahamut. I'll make sure enough is set aside for you, too.
Bahamut more understanding than Ominous. Food must share. What are you two bickering about?
Who? Idia! What are you doing here?
Delivering your garbage. Says right here, foodstuffs for the Ominous party. Idia have new job? Grand Marshal's daughter delivery girl? Lux and Dark Economy very harsh.
Current events.
I'm not a... Ugh! This is just a favor I'm doing for someone.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but did something happen to my dad?
Oh. You must be the delivery man's son.
Alavash, that's quite the family resemblance.
I'm Jambalai. Master Ominous hired me in Unohana.
Same for me. My name's Risotto.
I'm Paella. Please, tell us what happened to Jambalay's father. We've known him since we were all kids.
I wouldn't trust that Risotto guy. Especially not with all this metal equipment around here.
Just a little accident. A sprained ankle has him out of commission, so we came to make his delivery.
That's all, is it?
Yep, he's fine. No need to worry. In fact, we're supposed to contact him with any additional orders when we get back, so... I'm sure when we don't show up, he'll realize something's happened and send help.
That's true. We can count on my dad.
You said you were here to deliver some food, right? Well, hand it over. Finally, a decent meal.
Ominous, eat too much. Not fair.
Every meal, he always serves himself and that Dagon there, Bahamut, more than any of the rest of us.
He barely leaves a mouthful for us and Miss Artemia.
Didn't I tell you to hand over the food? Hurry it up! I'm starving here!
It's even worse than I thought it might be.
What a sound.
We better keep quiet about that food for a little while yet.
Yes, and it seems they've all eaten recently, even if it wasn't that much.
Oh, about that. You see, Ominous, the food we brought got buried under the rubble. Sorry.
What? Didn't you come here to deliver food? What kind of delivery girl are you? Of all the miserable... You're just as useless as the day we met!
Oh! Murkerker!
You're welcome to the food we have left, though there's not much.
Thank you. The offer alone is more than enough. Everyone must be worn out. Why don't we all just call it a night?
I'm in charge around here! I say when we call it a night, not you!
Yes, yes, of course, Master Ominous, sir. Won't you consider turning in for the night?
Don't you take that attitude with me! No one is to rest until I say...
I don't know, Ominous sounds different than it's supposed to. I know there's a couple other instances of that.
Another cave-in?
Having trouble sleeping?
Yeah. And I've just been thinking. Like you said, it looks like the food we hid is going to end up being very important. Artemius said that any food ought to be split evenly among everyone here.
But it seems Ominous is taking the lion's share for him and his pet.
He's never been a great leader, but I'd hope at least...
Well, he is the one funding this expedition and everything.
I know that, but still...
At this rate, those two will probably end up at each other's throats, and soon.
And when that happens...
It's getting cold. Come on, let's try to get some sleep.
Yeah. Good night, Tiz.
So this kind of fucks with the timeline a bit, doesn't it? Since we're going to be here for multiple days, it looks like. Whatever.
Keep trying, Bahamut! You're nearly there!
What was that noise just now? Ominous, what are you doing?
Idiot! Are you blind? Any idiot could see we're training! Look, we don't know if anyone will ever come for us. Bahamut mastering the ultimate monster magic might be our only chance of getting out of here!
The ultimate monster magic?
Getting tired, little buddy. Why don't you get yourself some rest? Looks like a crash course isn't gonna cut it.
Hey, you grunts! It's time to eat! Chop chop!
Of course, Master Ominous! Right away!
Is this a joke? What are these scraps?
But we're almost out of supplies. If we don't ration ourselves...
How many times do I have to say it? Bahamut is to be kept happy and full. What part of that can't you understand? Hand over your shares, too. Come on. Hey, don't you give me that look.
Ominous tyrant. Poor Bahamut. Bad master. Everyone have life. All life equal.
Equal, you say?
Don't be ridiculous. Nothing could be further from the truth! If someone is to survive, it should be the most skilled, the most able, the ones the world needs most!
Current events!
Hey! Don't give our food to Idia and her slacker friends, too! They're not even working for us!
But, sir...
No, it's fine. He's right. Don't worry about us.
Yes, we'll manage.
eat this. Artemia share hers.
Thanks, Artemia. I'd be honored to share with you. Please, have some of mine, too.
And mine.
Fools! Ah, do whatever you want! Just don't come groveling to me when you're hungry later. Bahamut and I won't be sharing.
It looks like there's only enough left for one more meal.
Indeed. We can hold out for a couple of days, but if a rescue party doesn't come soon...
Wow, look at you, Bahamut! You've licked your entire plate clean!
No one will deny that you're a cute one, Bahamut.
Hey, Ominous. What was that ultimate monster magic you were talking about?
What? Why should I have to tell you anything?
Is it true it's an ace in the hole for going up against a ball?
More or less. Not that you have any right to ask.
We've traveled all over and never heard of such a thing. What's the name of this spell?
Femto.
Huh? Femto?
Your toes! Hand them over!
Femto Flare. The ultimate monster magic. Femto Flare! When the Grand Marshal assigned us to those silly teens, I got stuck with that strange old man. He's the one who said I might be able to release the power of Femto.
So, in case you don't know, let's think back to Aerie at the end of Bravely Default. She used Zeta Flare. Zeta Flare is... Zeta is a prefix relating to 1 sextillion, 10 to the power of 21. Down from there is Exa, Peta, Terra, Giga, Mega, Kilo, Hecta, Dessa. He might, you know, Terabyte, Gigabyte, Mechabyte. But if you go down from there, you get Deci, which is 0.1, Centi for 0.01. Keep going down to 10 to the power of negative 15 for Femto Flare. I mean, I guess the old man playing a joke on this guy doesn't seem too out of character.
And if you can, it might get us out of here. So how do you use it?
Idiot! You think it's that easy? We're talking about ultimate magic here!
I was afraid you were gonna say that.
Ah, talking to you is just making me hungrier.
Shake coming! Big one! No more shake for now. Chance to rest. Thanks, Artemia. You're on a whole nother level, as usual. How do you sense these things? You don't know yourself? I see. Speaking of which, why did you become Ominous's bodyguard?
Get Ominous great magic. Get Ominous stronger and stronger.
Ah, you wanted to test yourself against Ominous at his strongest, huh?
Oh, Idia, read mind. True girl power. Respect.
Nope, you haven't changed a bit. Or maybe a little. Ominous's assistants are really fond of you. They look up to you more than Ominous, it seems.
Them honest.
They sure are.
Them, all from Unohana. Unohana parents take care of Artemia. Artemia owe much.
Miss Artemia, do you really think we'll get out of here alive?
Artemia not know.
Don't you worry, Risotto. My dad's on his way right now. I'm sure of it. He must be headed here with an enormous rescue party even as we speak. Why, any hour now.
Exactly. Try to keep your chin up.
I will.
You Artemias. Artemia protect Artemia's own. Roy!
We've been through worse, but for these poor kids, this is as rough as it gets.
I'm afraid so.
Are we at the conflict yet? Or are we just gonna keep sitting here with flavor and flavor and nothing else? Flavor.
Hmm?
Like food.
What do you want? Calling it a day already? I'm starved. We still had some food left, right?
Bahamut ate the last of what we had!
Well, what are you looking at me like that for? Listen up, you ingrate! I'm saying this for the last time! I'm the one paying your wages here, and Bahamut is my trusty partner! He's the second most important member of this expedition! Perhaps even the most important!
No understand. Give it a break, Ominous. Yelling is only gonna make you hungrier.
You're one to talk, idiot! You're the one who went and lost our extra food!
Yes, Master Ominous. It's all my fault. Forgive me for even breathing. As much as I'd love to stay awake and get yelled at some more, I'm gonna hit the sack. Night-night!
Wait! Don't you dare! The impertinent!
Hey, you awake?
Yeah. Looks like we can't hold out much longer, huh? You agree with Artemia about the food, don't you, Idia? Unless
it's true. About Femtoflare.
Right. Magic that can stop a ball? It's intriguing. But from Ominous?
D'accord. I must say that I'm intrigued. Magnolia, you're awake too? And you?
Yes. I'm also awake and equally interested.
I know it sounds good, but with the situation being what it is...
Maybe we should just get some sleep.
Yeah.
Toodies. Is it time for the decision yet? Day 3, dawn of the final day. Hopefully. I don't wanna... I'm sitting around doing absolutely nothing.
Bahamut! Don't eat my hood!
Why is Bahamut a Pokemon? Why is it only saying Baha?
Are you serious? It's all covered in slobber.
Morning. Ooh, looks like your day's off to a rough start, Ominous.
And I got you to thank for it! If only you hadn't lost that food!
That again? You know, no one likes a nag. Nag? Undisciplined? No one like Ominous.
Master Ominous? I'm afraid that we've finally reached the end of our food stores.
So this watery gruel is the last thing I'll ever taste? Ugh. And what do you think you're doing serving yourselves, huh? You should be giving every scrap you have to Bahamut.
That's it. I can't take any more of this.
Unfair, narrow-minded, cowardly, incompetent. Ominous never learn.
And neither do you. Always going on about how people are equal, how life should be fair. Balderdash!
Will this do, Master Ominous? It's the last we have.
Then hand it here! Bahamut, come here, fella! I've got your brekkie here, right here! Come on, Bahamut! What are you waiting for? Go on, eat! What's wrong with you, Bahamut?
Ominous, give it a rest. Even Bahamut is feeling guilty.
You don't understand anything. Femto Flare is the ultimate monster magic. We have no hope of using it without Bahamut.
You mean that's why you wanted him to have all that food? But even if Bahamut survives, what good will that do if no one else does?
You really don't understand anything, do you? You think I just want to get me and my buddy out of this place? All I want is for Bahamut to master Femto Flare and live through this disaster. That's all that matters. You know what damage that ball has done to our world already, don't you? It destroyed the entire western half of Eternia. Whole seas dried up. Mountains gouged out of the land. If we are to
when exactly?
That ball before it destroys our entire world, we need Bahamut and Femto Flare. If I can just help Bahamut master Femto Flare, I know he'll defeat the ball for us, even if I'm long since gone. You think I enjoy this? Well, I don't. But I'll sacrifice everyone here if I need to, even myself! Ah!
I understand, Master Ominous. I've seen you give your own portions to Bahamut day after day.
What?
I know you wake up earlier than anyone to keep practicing the spell. You must be hungriest of all, yet...
Ominous, you've really been doing all that?
Tell us more about this Femto Flare.
Even if I told you, you wouldn't understand.
Why can't we? Give us a chance, at least. Tell us what you're stuck on. Maybe we can help.
By unraveling the incantational bonds of a Jar-class spell and refining it to its purest form through extensive training, it should become possible for a familiar of the same elemental persuasion to master the ultimate monster magic, in theory.
So it's not just a matter of practice, but teaching it to Bahamut in the first place? Sounds almost impossible.
If Bahamut already knows fire,
as
yeah.
Should. They don't call it ultimate magic for nothing.
I assume the first step is learning the highest fire-type spell, Fireja. Is that right?
Yes, that's already out of the way.
Really? Ominous, you can use Fireja?
You really are always looking down on me, aren't you? You cheeky little...
Oh, that's dangerous.
Listen. In order to use the ultimate monster magic, Femto Flare, I have to first release the incantational bonds on Fireja. With enough training, it can then be acquired by a magical familiar, like Bahamut, as the ultimate form of monster magic. I have to quickly break the limits on Fireja. Then maybe 3 days of non-stop training. No sleep, no rest. But even if Bahamut masters the spell, the question then becomes whether he'll still have the stamina to use it. If we just had a bit more food, it would buy us enough time to save everyone. And now you know what I'm up against. So, shoo, let me work in peace. It takes more strength and focus than you can possibly imagine to unravel a spell like Fireja on the incantational level.
You mean you've already started?
I started the day we got trapped. I've managed to break through everything up to the fourth level. Just one more to go. What was it the old man said? The king of all summons meets his match with the Giga-class flare, while fey demons can even reach Zeta. Magical familiars are usually limited to the Pico class, but with the help of their human masters, this can be refined further. The ultimate monster magic, Femto Flare! We're nearly there, Bahamut! Nearly there!
So is monster magic just on an opposite scale? Is there a further class than Femto Flare?
Can we lay off
and it's called, like, Ato Flare?
Look, even your poor assistants are scared of you. I know Ominous is always setting you off. And now, that ultimate magic of his, Femto Flare, is that what's tickling your killer instinct? mind too much. Like sister. Maybe you never get married. Lay off, will ya? Never mind, Idia. But Ominous not fit to lead. I know.
Is Donald
like
a fae?
Bahamut notices other people's feelings more than Ominous does. Artemia, aren't you getting hungry? Artemia, disciplined. Hunger, nothing. Yeah, I'm hungry too. Artemia, Odette. Parents of these three, help Artemia. Treat Artemia good. Ask Artemia protect children. Artemia made promise. Protect, no matter what. Idia, all life equal. Leader, bodyguard, helper, all same. Life, all equal. Human, Dagon, Frosty, all same. Grand Marshal, Pope, Sister, Idia, all equal.
Yeah, we are.
We done? There's been no music either.
Someone! Come quickly! It's Risotto! He started trembling! And feel this! He's burning up!
Idia, move! Injury somewhere. Wound fester.
Check his foot! He said he stepped on something the other day.
Ew.
It's so swollen. Call for drastic measures. Hold arms and legs. Artemia, remove pus. Drink this. Stop infection. One foolish wave.
We'll make sure he drinks every drop.
Bahamut! No, that's...
Don't worry. It took three of us to move that huge rock.
Who voices Bahamut? Because they sound like they're having a good time.
That's not for you. Hands it to Auntie Idia, okay?
Idia! What's the meaning of this? That's my...
Ominous, wait. I can explain.
No.
Idia, hid food?
No, you can't.
Artemia, I'm sorry.
It was my idea. With everyone fighting over food, I thought we should set it aside until we really needed it.
I'm not sure what that accomplishes. What that accomplishes.
Please
here.
Please understand.
Never mind any of that. The good news is that there's food.
Artemia, understand.
Is there, like, something I'm missing? I don't get what benefit hiding food really has.
Look how little there is! How do you plan to share that?
What say, Ominous?
Foolish girl! Have you not been listening to a word I've said? If Bahamut can master the anti-ballistic femto flare, he will be the world's greatest hope! Got it? We need to focus on helping Bahamut in his training! Then, we have to ensure that he gets out of here alive! That is all that matters! That food has to be used for Bahamut's survival, and mine.
Ominous! Artemia say again and again, all life equal! Leader, bodyguard, slacker, all equal! Human, Dagon, all same! Any life can save world!
My father and the other townspeople. I'm sure they're coming to rescue us.
Shut your mouth, Lackey! Unless you insist on proving how stupid you truly are. Even if your father realizes something's wrong, how many days do you think it will take to form a search party and find us?
I mean, it only took like half a day for us to get here twice.
How many more days will it take to clear a way for us to get out?
I guess I never...
You never thought. Yes, that's obvious enough. Idia, hand the food over to me.
Idia, all life equal. Must share if we split the food up evenly, like Artemia says.
There won't be much to go around. Even with careful rationing, it won't last more than 2 or 3 days.
That's all? And if Ominous is to succeed in teaching Bahamut Femto's lair...
It might take 3 days, or longer. There's no way to know. Nor do we know if anyone's coming for us.
Oh, what should I do? We all deserve to survive. So does that mean I should do as Artemia says and divide the food evenly? Or is it more important for the world that Bahamut survives? Meaning I should give the food to Ominous?
They both seem deadly serious. Take care, Idia. Whichever choice you make, I have a feeling we'll be facing stiff opposition from the losing party.
This is no easy choice. What should I do?
Well, it's Black Mage or Hunter, and Hunter doesn't really offer much.
What have you decided, Idia?
The food should be shared evenly. It's the only fair thing to do. Idia!
But Idia...
I know what you want to say, Tiz. I understand it rationally, but...
This whole scenario needs like another rewrite.
This won't do. She blew it. What would the Templar think? And that old geezer? The girl you two trusted? This foolish girl and her fool friends? They've turned their backs on our world.
Oh no, a ball. No, it's not like we fought a ball already and we'll continue to fight balls throughout this game. Right. Time to fight. And we also all have fire resistant capes.
I've made up my mind.
This, I don't think this is going to be much of a challenge.
Forgive me, Grand Marshal, but I'm going to have to fry your fool daughter to a crisp. Come, Bahamut. We have to win this battle for the sake of the world. We have no choice. Burn them. Burn them all.
At least Kyle Hebert had fun.
You're about to face Black Mage Ominous Crow and his loyal partner, Bahamut. We will defeat you for Lux and Dark's sake. Aha!
Well, I also don't expect Bahamut to be particularly difficult, and we all resist fire. In fact, you even nullifies fire. Well. Might as well examine. Can I use Rejuvenation? Let's do that. Let's get some BP in the battery. And as for you... I suppose I should get your weapon rank up. Alright. It's only got 10,000 health. This battle is gonna be, not that difficult, I think. Frost, mist. Frost, hammer,
I'm back and better than ever.
Yeah.
Oh, congratulations.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, we do. So what's more effective? Frost Hammer or Frost Frost? That is equally as effective, it looks like. Is this tail in a different layer? That will never not be funny. Yeah, that was not that difficult. I mean, it was Pico Flare question mark. He couldn't even do that right. Anyways, you got black magic. Piercing defense is still a thing. Mandatory for any mage.
Ropes! Untie me at once!
Finally came to your senses, huh? After all that yelling at us to come to ours. Can't you take a hint from Bahamut and be a good boy?
Bahamut, you're all right?
Of course. All life equal.
Aha!
There we go. Evenly portioned. We have enough for 30 meals. Artemia, we three, and Idia's party makes 8 of us all together.
Bahamut, 9. Ominous, 10. All life equal. That's right. There's 10 of us. That leaves 3 meals per person. We'll just have to make it last until help comes. All right. We know you've been waiting, so come and get it. Chew it real good and savor every bite, too. No wolfing it down in one gulp. I'm looking at you, Bahamut.
Curse you all! Hurry and untie me! We might still have enough time! If I could just teach Femto Flare to Bahamut, if you would just let me try! Curse it!
How's Risotto?
Artemia's medicine is working, thank goodness. His fever's gone down.
Ah, that's a relief. Here, let's all take turns caring for him.
Thank you. I can watch him for now. Please, go rest.
Okay. We're going to make it through this, everyone. You hear me?
Yes, ma'am!
Where are we?
Back safe in Unohana. They've put us up in the bathhouse.
They found us. Is everyone okay?
We're all fine. You and Magnolia are up and moving too.
Artemia? The kids?
They all made it back safely. They're out getting food right now, in fact. We figured you'd be grouchy when you woke up with an empty stomach.
What about Ominous and Bahamut?
They both made it. They're helping out in the boiler room, preparing hot water for the baths.
Oh, thank goodness.
What's wrong? Are you still having second thoughts? Going against Ominous and giving up on the Femto Flare?
No. I don't regret anything. I'd make the same decision again if I had to. Besides, I'm sure those two will master Femto Flare someday.
Yeah. I imagine they will.
A la vache, c'est magnifique! Oh my, what a splendid banquet! Miss Idia, the townspeople have all come to express their thanks!
So what was this expedition even about, anyways?
Prepare your stomach, Idia. I see a great feast in our future.
I've heard reports that in the Japanese version, the moral dilemma is whether or not to eat Bahamut. But that might not be true, to be honest. There was a lot of debate over quote-unquote censorship in this game because of the change in, the change in Amy's outfit. I don't want to get into this discussion right now because there's a lot of nuance that is very much lost in these sorts of arguments. Anyways, let's see what we can get. Serrated shield. I suppose it could be good for Tiz. I mean, I'm gonna buy it anyways because, like, yeah, but which of these hats is the best? This one provides magic defense, but at a significant, well, somewhat significant cost to physical defense. Definitely buy one for Magnolia, because she could use the magic attack and magic defense. But as for these, it looks like the Hachigane is just the better option. Well, no. Well. Okay, I want one Kabuto for Iria and two Hachiganes for you and Tiz, it looks like. And then agility by two. Interesting. So I lose magic attack and magic defense, but I gain some agility and better physical defense than this stuff. Except for this, where Iria is. Yeah. I definitely want this for Iria. This for Tiz for sure, and then two of these for you and Magnolia. And then that should be everything. So now money can go to saving for the next necessity, I suppose. Okay. Why did I? Well, I still need to buy one of each for the journal, but I am. Oh boy. Ay. Definitely want that for you because you can take a weakness to magical attacks, especially if your physical is better. You want the aesthetics cap and the Suzukake. Same for you. You want the Hachigane and the Suzukake. Okay.
Why, hello. It's so nice to see you again. Will you be staying the night? Or are you just here for a quick bath? We have rose baths today. Every bath is filled with beautiful petals and exfoliating thorns.
That sounds great, Sakura. But actually, we could really use your help.
Why are we asking her? Like, we need a boat. Why are we asking her?
A ship, you say? I fear I'm just a humble stewardess. You should speak with Lord Arima.
Yeah.
Lord Arima?
Yes, the Lord of Yunohana. If you visit the castle, he should be happy to grant you an audience.
That makes sense. Thanks. Well, let's go see if this lord has a ship for us.
Okay. Let's see here. Fully healed. so let's just save the game normally. Let's go. Alright, this part of the game.
Welcome, travelers. I am Kusatsu Arimar IV, Lord of the Baths. Your arrival in our nation has made quite the splash. I hear it, you fight the Empire. If you need anything at all, just say the word. I will happily pool my resources for you.
Oh no.
Thank you, your lordship. As a matter of fact...
A ship, you say? Why, that's as simple as soap and water.
Current events?
My favorite lacquered gondola is at the docks, adorned ornately with the Arimar family crest. Please, think of it as your own.
Another rowboat? Actually, we were looking for something a bit more ocean-worthy. And bigger.
That's one idea down the drain. And yet, I fear it is my only vessel. If only there were some way to... But no, that's impossible.
What's impossible?
Alas, an intractable clog. If you wish to venture into the open seas, I suggest you wait for a merchant vessel to call it port.
But how long is that gonna take?
What are we gonna do?
Now, my friends, no need to get so lathered up.
Please stop.
Come, let us nibble on something sweet, and we shall ponder this bubblesome issue together.
Oh my god.
Did you say something sweet?
I did. It just so happens a traveling confectioner was recently drawn to our baths. He presented me with an offering of desserts. But I fear they will be too sweet for my sophisticated palate. Perhaps you will find them more to your liking.
Hey, I bet these are from that traveling pastry chef we met back in Hartschild.
Oh no, oh dear.
What luck! Maybe he has a boat for us too.
Why would he have a boat?
It's worth asking.
Actually, no, he's just traveling.
Oh, different.
What am I thinking?
Let's each pick one, and then we can go look for him. I don't care much for sweets either, so I'll just have whatever's left over.
Then it's just the three of us. First come, first served. Oh, they all look so yummy. I think I'll have un petit minute. What do you think you're doing? That's the one I wanted.
Settle down, you two. There's no use fighting over cake.
Right, let's unclench those fists now. No, you don't need to crack your knuckles.
I know. Why don't we let you decide who gets first dibs?
Good idea. I'm sure you will choose wisely. Won't you, you?
Murderer.
Why do I feel like I'm being sandbagged? You... I'm trusting you won't be swayed by any saucy wiles. Got it?
Right. Whatever you say. In that case...
Okay, so... I have foresight. I know what this is leading to. And there is a right answer here. But admittedly, it is kind of funny if you picked his... Oh, this fight totally sucks. I'm gonna go with my foresight gut.
I love verse! I go first! And I pick this one. The honey and nectar drizzled blooming bavarois with party-colored flower petals and a dusting of pollen. It's almost too beautiful to eat, but eat it I must! Here goes! Oh la la! So magnifique, I could just die! Is it really that good? Heavens, is it ever!
waistline of butterflies, dancing on my tongue, wearing little shoes of infinite delight. C'est divine!
Food porn, food porn, food porn, food porn, food
porn. Whoa! It's so good she's lapsing into moonlish! Well, guess it's my turn!
Alright! Wait, what happened to Magnolia? Magnolia? Are you alright? Magnolia!
I kind of wish she just, like, deposed.
Something's definitely wrong. It's like she can't even hear us. I feel like I've seen this look before. Of course, the people in Hartschild. There must be something in the cake!
Bazooks! Could it have been poisoned?
Shut up.
I don't know, but we shouldn't eat anymore. Let's throw it out.
That's no way to treat my delectable delicacies.
I remember you. You're the pastry chef from Hartsfest. What did you put in the cake?
No artificial ingredients, if that's what you're implying. Just pure, unadulterated genius. My creations don't just taste magical, you see. They have certain effects on the eater. These cakes include an extra dash of inspiration I added just for you. Taste and behold the result, my dear diners. A one-way ticket to heaven.
Huh? Qu'est-ce qui m'arrive? What's happening to me?
Magnolia!
I'm disappearing!
What did you do to her?
Didn't we just go over this? My cakes are so divine, anyone who tastes one is whisked straight off to heaven. Of course, in heaven you have no body, and you can't move or talk. I like to call it death by delicious.
Wait a minute. It was you, wasn't it? All those poor people in Hartschild!
That's right. And they savored every moment.
This doesn't make any sense. Unless you're working for...
Angelo Ovio Panettone, Patissier Nonpareil. Charmed, I'm sure. Personal confectioner to the Kaiser, and proud owner of the Patissier Asterisk. My boss was sick of you meddling in his affairs, so here I am. Ladies!
Yes, Chef!
Right on cue. Now let's hear it. My sweets are...
To die for!
My face is...
To die for!
And these losers can...
Go to heaven!
It's time for dessert! Lick their plates clean!
I am Angelo
Panettone, holder of the Patissier Asterisk. By whisk and by spatula, I create a profusion of pastries, a symphony of sweets. The women of the world swoon at the taste of my delicacies and the sight of my face.
So... Yeah, Magnolia is a ghost. And ghosts can only use magic. And they're always treated as having zero HP. They cannot be targeted for anything. I don't know. I can't target her. I think it just auto-redirects someone else, but I'm not sure. But if you lose, if you, Idia, and Tiz all go down, while Magnolia is a ghost, you lose. That zero HP, though, that has a bit of a side effect if you picked Red Mage earlier. See, Red Mage has a skill called MP-free in a pinch. When you're at less than 20% health, you consume no MP when using magic, or any skills, for that matter. So ghosts just get free spells. Have fun with that. Anyways, Angelo. Anjuro. Yo, Angela. Yeah, ghosts can't really do anything. They can't even use items. If you pick a non-magic user, you can't. If you pick a non-magic user, all you can do is, you can't even summon friends. Actually, I don't know. Yeah, it looks like you can't even summon friends. All you can do is default and just wait for the inevitable. So, I guess the correct answer here is to kill the medic first. This motherfucker right here. Kill him first. Or her first in this case. Sponge cake! It is physical defense is lowered. The Patissier is kind of like, kind of like the self-maker, in a way, but definitely less effective. There's some interesting applications for the Patissier, especially in regards to the, or in relation to the pirate, which has the ability to inflict more damage based on the opponent's number of debuffs, and this can apply many debuffs very quickly, but it's no self-maker, that's for sure.
Who took out Amy?
Wait, you're the darling she was going on about?
Don't remind me. Yes, she was fond of that word. But I assure you, I was not her darling. I show her a little bit of kindness, and the woman is hopelessly enamored with me. Not the first time that's happened, of course. But over and over, sweetie this, darling that. I can't stand the clingy types.
You're a real jerk, you know that? Can't you see that she loved you?
That's rich, coming from a kid who beat her in battle. You think I wanted to come all the way out here to play babysitter? Yet here I am, all because she couldn't take care of business. That woman continues to give me nothing but grief.
Another sponge cake. This game does anything really well, it's, it makes me really hungry.
You cared about that girl, didn't you? Why else would you come looking for revenge?
Revenge? Is that what you think this is about? That girl was nothing more than a tool to me. Like my spatula. If my spatula broke, you bet I'd be annoyed.
I actually feel sorry for you. You had someone who really cared about you. And you're comparing her to a spatula!
You're really starting to get on my nerves. What do you know about me? What happened between Amy and I is our business. So shut up and die already!
He sounds... I was gonna say he sounds like Felix, but I don't know if that's right. Max Middleman. Yeah, I guess I can see it. But he wasn't Felix. Let's see here. Hmm.
This is a fight. Oh. I feel like I should have gotten White Mage in hindsight, but I don't know. Max weapon rank, so one ton destruction it is. Oh. Oh dear. Oh. Thank you for that. Let's see here. It is low on health. I don't really have any regular healing items. You know what I should do? I've got this. I might as well use it. And you need to get back into your stances. Yeah, it is going to be a pretty solid damage dealer. Quite a while, it looks like. This is my video. Probably just keep healing. As much as I appreciate, as much as I would appreciate the extra DPS, I think Idia's got that covered. And, healing's probably more important right now, it looks like. I think we're good in terms of damage. Idia is putting out 7 to 10 times what Yu is putting out. Well, I guess Idia costs BP, so it's more like 3 to 5 times, whatever. More reinforcements. Oh, thanks for that. More healing, probably. Revive Idia. First, I thought, did Max Mobile do anything at all for 3 houses? Damn, he really... That can't be right. He's... Oh, he's Gray and Echoes. Okay, Gordon, Gray, Leo, Caden. Okay, yep. And Forest, okay. He's in Fire Emblem, just not 3 houses. I knew I was thinking of something.
heat. If I heat, heat, hammer. Should be exactly what I need. And then you just attack. We're good. At least ghosts still get experience as opposed to dead party members. And we got the Patissier, which I think can apply ghost, but it only has a chance to. It's a pro dagger class, and daggers are the weakest weapon type in the game. So what this is really good at is applying. There's some side effects that this is basically the only way to apply, or only realistic way to apply. Like, no vampire means charm's harder to apply. You could apply weakness statuses. Again, much like the, much like Soundmaker. It's not that great, though. Especially for me with money as tight as it is.
My genius ruined! My pride! My passion! That I suffer the same fate as that woman is just icing on the bitter cake of defeat. What are you waiting for? Finish me and end this cruel farce.
Oh yeah, I hear the Ryuji.
You don't want to dirty your spotless hands? To think I lost to the likes of you? Then you leave me no choice but to do the deed myself. Heaven, here I come!
What? No! Put down the cake!
This ring. It's that cheap trinket I gave Amy. There's a note tied to it.
To my sweet darling. If you're reading this, I guess it means I'm pushing up daisies. I'm sorry for letting you down. I was never good enough for you. But I loved you more than anyone in the whole wide world. Growing up in the woods, all I ever ate was roots and bark and wild animals and stuff. I didn't even know what cake was until we met. But that first bite I took, holy cow! I couldn't believe anything so sweet could exist in this world. So I decided I'd be sticking with you, whether you liked it or not. If I hadn't have met you, I probably never would have seen the outside of those woods. You made my world a bigger place, darling. Thank you. Your sweet sugar cake, Amy. P.S. You want to know what made me happiest? When I slept in on Sundays and you made me your special pancakes. I'd give anything just to taste them again. So listen, if you ever loved me, even just for a second, do me one last favor. Stop fighting. Open a pancake shop instead. Then everyone in the world can be as happy as I was.
Pancakes sound really nice right now, actually.
Sweet darling, 1,000 times I asked her. Even now, in my lowest moment of failure, she won't knock it off. Aggravating to the end. That woman.
Oh, where are you going?
Next time we meet, you'll get your just desserts. I'll serve you the best pancakes you've ever had.
So he's allowed to live.
Phew. He was one tough cookie.
Wait, aren't we forgetting something?
Yeah, I forgot.
It's Magnolia. We never asked him to bring her back.
If we forgot something, it wasn't that important.
Oh no, now what do we do? We have no idea where she was headed either.
We can't just leave her like this.
Magnolia's scared. I can't see her, but I can tell. Me too. We have to do something.
Well done, my noble friends. You washed the dirty scoundrel right out of our hair.
Stop.
It was a schwitz watching from my comfortable hiding spot, but I never saw a truer display of heroism. If not for your quick action, our peaceful nation would truly be in hot water. As a token of my eternal gratitude, I would bestow upon you a lifetime Yuno-hana bathport.
A bathport?
Yes, like a passport, but with a B and a lisp. With it, you are free to make use of our baths whenever you wish.
That's very generous of you, your lordship, but we don't have much time for hanging out in hot springs. Wait a minute. Of course! The hot springs! The baths here are supposed to cure all ills. Maybe it would work on Magnolia, too!
Really? Sounds like a long shot.
It's worth a try. I'll go get a bucket of water. Here it is. Oh, that's hot. Magnolia must be somewhere around here. Try splashing it around. Okay, here it goes.
Grace, I should!
Look, she's back! Wow, it really worked!
It's a little scary how well it works. But all's well that ends well. Without a doubt. Oh, la vache, I thought I was going to be stuck like that forever.
There's nothing a good bath can't solve. Indeed, cleanliness is next to godliness. Now that that mess is all cleaned up, I insist you stay the night and enjoy our hospitality.
Stop!
You know, a bath would be good right now. What do you say, everyone?
Well, hopefully we're done with puns forever. I mean, I love puns, but I also hate puns. You're supposed to hate puns. That's the joke. But Haas Bathtality is not even trying. Even Hot Bathtality. That might be a little better. Into the bath we go.
Ooh, ah, that's the ticket. Ah, tell me about it. Take a look at this, sir. I've been working out. 20 push-ups and 20 sit-ups every night. What do you think? Am I looking more manly? You sure are. My routine is 50 each, morning and night, you know. Wow, sir.
Excuse me, gentlemen. I heard all about your bravery from Lord Arima's valet. He tells me you saved our town.
Oh, no. We just did what we had to do.
That's not what I heard. I think you're being far too modest.
Well, it was a tough fight.
In any case, your dinner is ready. Please, enjoy it while it's still hot.
Oh, thank you. We'll just dry off and be
coming! Idia! Idia, your clothes!
What?
Ooh, now that was delicious.
No kidding. What a feast. I'm completely stuffed. I'm so glad you liked it. It's always nice for a cook to know her efforts weren't in vain.
Wait, you made all this?
Oh yes, as the sole employee of this bathhouse, I'm responsible for everything. Cleaning the baths, managing the front desk, preparing the meals, whatever needs to be done. Get out. That's amazing! You're like the Omega Weapon of Innkeepers! Why, thank you. I think. It's nothing, really. Will you be retiring for the night soon?
Yeah, I'm pretty sleepy.
Lord Arima sent over a tremendous amount of yuzu, so I prepared yuzu baths for this evening. Perhaps you'd like to enter once more before turning in. Yuzu baths? What's that?
Yuzu. It's a citrus fruit. You bathe with whole fruits floating in the water.
It will warm you to the bones, and it's wonderful for your skin. That sounds lovely.
Well, I'd hate to miss the chance, so I think I'll try it out.
I would too, but I'm really beat. I think I'll... hit the hay.
Me too. I might have overdone it. I gotta lie down and digest.
Alright, see you later then. This is the life. The scent of yuzu is so refreshing. I could do this every night. Hey, Magnolia? Are you there?
Yes? What is it?
I just wanted to say... I'm sorry. You know, about the flower? The moon. Its customs. I really have no idea.
Don't worry about it. It was my fault for leaping to conclusions. I mean, of course you wouldn't propose to me on our very first meeting. Although, I really was happy. I even considered saying yes, right then and there.
Really? But why?
It's a secret. But it wasn't quite love at first sight, if that's what you're thinking.
A secret? But you'll tell me someday, right?
Peut-être. I'll think about it. Too bad we can't stay like this.
Yeah. The Skyhold is still out there. That's our main worry. And we still need to find an ocean-worthy ship.
I wish we could do something for the people of Heartschild, too. We could bring the spring water to them, but it seems it's not as effective once it cools off.
And as long as they're in that gone to heaven go state, they aren't coming here. We can't take the hot springs to them, and we can't bring them to the hot springs. There must be a way.
You seem troubled, my young friends.
I know that voice. You're the man with the purple pen.
That's a curious name you've given me. Though I suppose it's better than stalker or ghost.
I've got another name for you if you want. Peeping Tom.
I assure you, I'd never dream of doing such a thing. My intentions are nothing if not noble. My only desire is to help. Opportunities are like bean sprouts. Use them while you can, or they'll be spoiled before you know it.
Well, that sounds great. But what are you talking about?
Your ship is right before your eyes. Now you need only use it.
What? I don't see any ship.
Lord Arima's intractable clog. I've taken the liberty of tracting it. Anchors away.
Whoa! What the...
It was a boat the whole time.
You? Magnolia? What the heck's going on?
It wasn't us. Honest.
What's with all the racket? I was having such a good sleep.
We were in the bath when the man with the purple pen showed up.
The man with the purple pen?
Yes, I heard him too. You mean he's here? In the bathhouse?
His voice was coming from upstairs. Let's check it out.
I'm sorry if I seem distracted. I actually ended up witnessing the sandwich debate in a text chat. But if this was behind here the whole time, why didn't we discover it when we came up here?
Huh? What's a ship's wheel doing here? Don't tell me.
This is where it sounded like the man with the purple pen was.
Well, he's not here now. Where's he always off to so suddenly?
Her bathing! She moves! Oh!
thought we were done.
Why, look at this room. I thought it was only for storing the linens.
You've never explored
Sakura.
At all?
To think there was a soul who could write her plumbing. Truly, my tub runneth over.
Your lordship, I beg of you, please lend us this vessel. We want to take its healing waters to Hartschild. If the water is still hot, we'll be able to cure the townspeople.
Not content to save our nation alone, you intend to scrub Hartschild free of its troubles as well? It would ill behoove me to throw a wet towel on your ambition. This vessel was the very rubber duck of Yunohana, but from this day forth, she belongs to you. After you have saved Hartschild, journey with her wherever you need to pull the plug on the Kaiser.
Thank you very back. We shall'n't let you down. All right, time to bring the hot springs to Hartschild.
This is a far cry from our old boat. Does anyone know how to pilot it? More or less.
Oh, someone's been studying.
Really? Oh, well, I'll figure it out. All right, I can do this.
Way to go, Idia. Helm, set a course for Hartschild.
Aye, Captain. Ringing her about. Full steam ahead!
So, you better hope Hartschild has more hot springs, because we're just taking this place's, like, primary source of revenue with us. But, I mean, the entire world is open to us now, I suppose. We also have more enemies that I'll eventually have to grind out. These enemies are dangerous. Jesus. Thought it said we were back up to 20,000. That'd be crazy. I know this isn't gonna be enough. But I'd rather save up SP while I can, or BP while I can. He's got this to deal with. The rabbies on the water. I love charm. Does the beastie give us any insight as to why the rabbies are on the water? Not yet.
Well, I guess that's where these flakes are coming from. Okay. At the very least, at any time you can enter the ship. And go into the bath for an instant heal. It's very appreciated after the first game still charge you for in usage even when you were the only ones using the goddamn grand ship. Whatever. Why are the rabbits of all things so friggin' chunky? That's a shark. I guess I could do lightning damage to Deus Ex. Magnolia is dead. Okay. It looks like these free healings are going to be more appreciated than I realized. Am I okay? That was not a sentence. Looks like these free healings are going to be more useful than I thought. There, that's a real sentence that real people really say. Admittedly, I'd much rather pay the toll and have the adventure on here just for it. Instant heal, but what are you gonna do? next fight is a little rough.
My.
If memory serves.
So this is the coast of Hearts Child.
That's right. Hey, wait a minute. You're still on board.
Of course. Why wouldn't I be?
It's just that, we kind of get into a lot of dangerous situations.
As you've seen by all the fish.
Then all the more reason. I'll stay right here. On a perilous journey such as yours, you're bound to have aches and pains from time to time. When that happens, I'll be here to see you're as comfortable as possible. Does that mean you'll be cooking for us too? But of course, hot meals thrice daily. Now that's what I'm talking about!
I guess we're... I mean, we are cooking... blah, blah, blah. We are killing enough fish for... resources. Ugh! Magnolia is dead. John, are you okay? No. Garfield, are you okay? Garfield is dead. Give me a sec. Let's go to the ship. There's going to be plenty of boat journeys, so I'm not going to worry about grinding out all the open sea enemies. I hope that the open sea is the same everywhere. Walk around in circles. Huh. He's just thinking there. He's just sitting there doing poses. That's so weird. For what purpose? That's spoilers. But I guess by saying that's spoilers, well, we'll get to that. We'll get to it eventually. It's something that I don't want to spoil because the way this game handles it is so unique that I feel like people who haven't seen it before, it's something that I want to keep a fresh experience, as opposed to some of the plot points in the original game, which I did kind of spoil willy-nilly. Oh wait, is the boss fight? I know there's a boss fight like in this time frame, I think.
Nope, there's no one inside either. Everybody went to heaven.
Huh? What's that sound? It's coming from outside.
Oh yeah,
the city,
it's right now.
And it's getting closer.
Oh, this one's a bit of a doozy.
Sergeant Sapp, sir! We're almost at Hearts Child, sir!
No thanks to this rat's a fracking machine! We should have been here days ago!
Don't be too hard on him, Sergeant Sapp, sir! He did his best to only overheat at breakfast, lunch, and dinner, sir!
We could have been the ones to take the city, too! Oh well, might as well mop up.
Hello, Patrick Seats.
Level the place and get a move on, or His Majesty will leave us behind.
Huh? Sergeant Sapp, sir. I think someone's coming this way, sir.
No matter. If they get in the way, just level them too.
Hello, Pat Seats. Also, hello, Japanese
what
background music.
Is that? That's the Imperial insignia on it. What clunky, primitive technology.
It's so cool.
I know, right? It's so rustic and rugged looking.
You two, quit gawking and get ready to fight. It's coming for us.
This fight in particular, I was at for quite a while. Maybe if Super Dreadnought Bale. I guess it's supposed to be Super Dreadnought Bale. So it's a rank 10 train. Huh. Let me see here. So it's got three targets. We got Sat Piddler and the Bale. And it overheated, huh? Punch Piddler. And Slice Sap. I am on a PC using Citra to emulate this. It's a 3DS emulator that is a little cumbersome at times, but honestly, I can't really complain. It's mostly worked pretty well, and the up-res of the graphics has made this game look quite beautiful, to be honest. It just makes me wish we had this game on a home console so we didn't have to deal with all the artifacting. Anyways, the bale itself is weak to water. Water. Frost Frost. Yeah. There's a lot of things that are very different after playing Three Houses. Like, the relic weapon for the White Mage in Final Fantasy XIV. The relic weapon in Final Fantasy XIV for the White Mage is the Lysithia's true weapon. Let's see here. Piddler's almost dead. The sound it says, the sound it makes when you use the perforator, it kind of sounds like the sound that, that Omega Flower makes when you hurt it. Yeah. Let's heal up. One-ton destruction should be. I'm only at base speed. I should be at least double speed. Our Piddler's down for now. Sap is about dead, so you just attack Sap normally. He's down too, so now we just have to deal with the Bale. Double Frost Frost. Double Wonton. Magnolia's damage is certainly falling behind, unfortunately.
Climb Mount Fragmentum 0002.
Sir, yes, sir. Increasing boiler temperature.
Don't lower it by mistake, Private. Whatever you do. Got it?
I should have waited. I have an idea. No, katanas. Weapons do water-based damage, huh? Sounds like exactly what we need. Thank you. and it's not doing any damage, but admittedly, it's, I don't have any healing items. And Magnolia. Well, what I should do is an Opal Mushroom on Magnolia.
Boiler temperature at 50%, sir!
Just so she doesn't die. Hildler's back.
Boiler temperature at 100%, sir! Ready for liftoff, sir!
Oh dear. Well, that's bad. And I don't have any healing items, and that thing has 15,000 health left.
Let's give him all we've got.
I had SP. Why was I not using SP? I should have used... You know, I had ways out of that. I had a way out of that. At least I saved at a decent location so I don't have to go all the way back. Okay. Okay, new plan. Magnolia needs to keep her BP as high as possible. So you just use your normal attacks and contribute in normal ways. Idia, on the other hand, needs to get her weapon rank as high as possible so she can spam wanton destruction as much as possible. And Tiz can do whatever. She's at max proficiency. To use this now, even if it would give me BP. Let's wait on it. Does not seem like a waste anymore. And then I suppose I should be trying to focus on Bale or on Sap and Piddler over Bale, because that takes out attacks per turn.
Leave it to moi.
Please give me BP. Please get Adia back into the fight. Thank you very much. Alright. Nice spell. Frost. Spam wanton destruction. Just using one attack. That was 8,000 damage. That was almost the damage cap right there. Okay, so don't lower it by mistake. Okay. So, is it frost? What's the solution? Or do I heat it up even further? I feel like there's a better solution here, but just spam frost. Continue the special attack chain, please. There we go. Special attacks will continue. This might actually just kill him flat out. But he is very strong right now. Yeah, no, we win. We're good. There's the damage cap! I just realized, that's Patrick Seitz declaring glory to the Empire. Huh. 3 years before Three Houses, we get Patrick Seitz again.
Preposterous! The pride of our army, our next generation super weapon, humbled by four mere gutter snipes!
Sergeant Sam, sir, a message for
is...
you. Don't worry, I decoded it. Skyfold, Diam, and T sails, fro next ob, ject ive at dawn. Or something like that, sir. Ret earn post faced or be ab and dunned. Well, I don't want to be ab or dunned, sir. Furthermore, do not let unit fallen to any my F ands. The end. Ands what? Talk about a cliffhanger, sir. Oh, wait, there's also something about a coward Meridial and a firing squid.
Ooh, and we got no choice. Pull the self-destruct lever!
But, sir!
Just do it! We can't let the weapon fall into enemy hands!
I can't do it, sir. The lever's broke clean off, sir.
Why, I'll break your... Fine. We'll drive the blasted thing back. About face!
Wouldn't it be faster if we walked? And what about my face, sir?
Just shut up!
Look at that thing clanking and clunking away. What a rust bucket. It's so cool!
I wish I had one. Anyway, now that that's over, what do we do about Heart's Child?
We'll need to douse every inch of the city, but how can we do that without the water getting cold?
I know! We could spray the whole town at once with a great big shower!
Yeah, good idea. Let's do that. Idia, you get the giant shower and we'll wait here.
Murder.
No, it is a good idea.
You piece of shit.
If we just connect that to the bathhouse,
Nice thinking, sir. Don't jinx me.
Anyway, the pipe leading to the fountain should be right over there. Great, let's get to work.
Okay, that should do it.
All right, open the valve and start pumping.
Is it raining? But it's so warm. I can see everyone. And look, I can move again.
But everyone not in this immediate vicinity can go fuck themselves.
The townspeople are back to normal. We brought the heart back to Heart's Child. Good job, everyone.
All right, so we saved Heart's Child.
And you're dead again. Thank
thanks to you, I'm feeling as good as ever. We're happy to see you back on your feet, sir.
But now, he must return to the battlefield. Of course, I'm grateful that he's well again. It's just, a part of me can't help feeling sad as well.
I'm sorry, Eleanor, but I promise I shall return to you unharmed.
Oh, my love.
Woo-hoo-hoo! Getting awful steamy in here. And I ain't just talking about the hot spring. I've never seen two people who care for each other so deeply. And yet, despite that deep love, their lives force them apart. He must protect the nation, and she must protect their home for when he returns. Their love is suffocated and crushed under the heavy weight of duty. Duty. Such a simple word. Yet it has the power to keep two loving souls apart. In the end, what does such a marriage mean? What is it all for?
Wow. What's gotten into Magnolia?
She seemed really affected by that conversation with the Goodmans.
Maybe being married means even more on the moon than it does down here on Luxendark.
Still, I know how she feels. What I wouldn't give to experience true love like the Goodmans someday.
Mm-hmm. Does this mean you're about to launch into a monologue too?
Unacceptable.
All right, everyone. Ready to go? Let's do it! To the Temple of Water!
Speaking of unacceptable... Which one? Oh yeah, you miss him. He ran off because Amy's bullet finally landed. It had a ring with a note on it for telling him to go make go open a pancake shop instead of fighting. Ah, shit! I keep skipping it! Ugh, wait. That was a funny one, too. Hold on. There's supposed to be, like, a... Wait, I think it's in the journal. Yeah, event viewer, here we go. I love that Idia and you have this bond, this thing to bond over, like, them specifically. Mean an ace ass in. What does that mean? War hero. It could be beautiful. Okay, also this is open during the day again. Thank God for convenience. I could just go on the boat, but I don't care. It's convenient to stay at the inn. Okay, so now that we're done here, I guess it's time to progress with the plot. Oh, that's real good, actually. That's really good. Oh god, what's happening to the frame rate? Hold on, I know how to fix this. There we go. I still do need to fight these guys, so. Sure. Whatever works. Back on the boat. Let's go to,
Look, the Skyhold is on the move again.
It's headed for the Temple of Water.
There, yeah.
There's no time to lose. Let's give chase in the Rub-a-Dub. Idia, take the helm.
Hold on. The Rub-a-Dub?
We have to call it something, right?
The man with the purple pen, the Rub-a-Dub. Where do you come up with these names? I can't decide if they're strange, or silly, or just way too obvious.
Oh, you don't like it? Well, I had other ideas. The Leisure Liner Bathtastic, Sauna Sloopy, the HMS Hot Spa.
Oh, you missed a bunch of puns, too.
Let's just stick with Rub-a-Dub.
Rub-a-Dub it is!
Oh, wait, how about the Battleship Bubble Bath?
Rub-a-Dub, moving out!
Alright, so, Water Place, whose name is kind of escaping me at the moment, whatever. Flarum, that's it. We're going to Flarum. It's like the fucking Danger Earth 3. We're going to France! We're going to Italy! That was a terrible impression. Huh? We're going to We're going to France. No, I can't do Strong Bad. We're going to France. No. My two idiot brothers. No. What's a. I can't. I cannot do a Strong Bad voice. Anyways. Do this for every fight we can. When did Magnolia get almost dead? Boat. I wish you could just talk to her and get like a instant heal, but whatever, gotta go in here, wait for you to change clothes, and get back in, wait for you to change clothes. I think we're gonna be seeing this a lot. Helldiver. That's the name of a game, I think, but I don't remember what it's about. I think I only remember it from What Happened. And by From What Happened, I mean, I think Matt mentioned it once on What Happened, but I don't. I don't know, I might be thinking of something else he mentioned. Out of mana. Uses out of mana's ain't Yoga. You out of mana. You can't use any of your magic. Yeah. You can't use any of his magic when he's out of MP. Oh, Jesus Christ. Hey, you, the fuck is your deal? You just sit there and did nothing while we got the shit beat out of us. I could just sit here and do impressions for an hour. That sounds like entertaining stream material, but I don't know. I should stream a game where, like, I don't care about the plot, so I have an excuse and or... I'm either an excuse or, like, am forced to not talk about the game. As much as I like talking about this game, I can't deny it'd be easier to... Or rather, I can't deny that I need to improve my conversational skills. I need something to, like, and to be able to talk to people and appeal to me and my audience. And this game's great, but it's so plot heavy that I just stay silent for a lot of the plot details. So it's I don't know. It's a weird problem to have. Definitely can't deny that I need better conversation skills, especially because, like, I need to be able to justify streaming when the audience is not there. Right now, I cannot do that. I do not have the ability to carry streams for myself. Right now I mostly play games on stream, kind of in a similar way to the way I just play myself, where I just kind of narrate my actions. Alright, and before we ground, let's... The rub-a-dub, this one, yeah, it's. I think I like it more than the Grand Ship. The Grand Ship is a little generic. This one, I mean, the way it fits into the story is a little silly, considering we're basically taking a country's main, like, we're taking the main reason to visit a country and taking it and leaving, but admittedly, it is a striking visual design. Anyways, land. We're in Flarum. We're in Flora.
Look, it's the Skyhold.
There's no doubt about it. It's heading for the Temple of Water. Skyhold! It's on fire!
Someone's attacking the Skyhold! But if not us, who?
Memory.
the cruelest and most beautiful of gifts. We look back at the days gone by, and only too late see them for what they were. The more we come to learn, the greater our regrets. Our sorrows grow. You may learn truths you wish you had never known, but stay proud. What you believed in yesterday has not lost meaning because of what you learned today. Someday you will see for yourself, when you look back upon your life, that each day served a purpose in shaping you into the person you were meant to be.
Do 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 do. Skipping this. It's the same cutscene and also gets me copyright striked. Or at least the VOD muted.
The Skyhold's really burning. It's headed for the other side of the mountains.
Looks like it took some real damage.
Agnes, are you all right?
Huh? Oh, yes, I am fine. There was a jolt just now, but... Oh, drat! She seems fine. What's wrong? That jolt scattered magnetic supplies all about the room. I simply can't find my red yarn anywhere. Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Was there something you needed?
Someone attacked the Skyhold.
Attacked? But who?
We're not sure. Can you tell us how things are there?
I see considerable smoke, and everyone is racing about outside. It seems there are quite a few wounded as well. Oh, I do hope everyone is okay.
Got it. Given the situation, there's no telling what'll happen next. Take care of yourself. And Agnes, I can see your red yarn under the suit of armor behind you. The one on your right?
Oh, Diz! Thank you so much.
Well, at least we know she's doing fine. Almost more than fine from the sound of it. But what was that light? Who could be attacking the Skyhold?
A transmission from Fatloon. Appleberry, what's going on?
I was hoping you could tell me, Magnolia. We picked up a massive SP reading from Luxendark just now.
SP? From Luxendark?
The numbers were completely off the charts. You don't know anything about it.
We saw a huge beam of light just now. Could that be...
A beam of light, you say? We'll need to know more. Investigate it, Ballbuster.
Roger that. I'll notify you once I've learned more.
Magnolia, what's going on? SP readings?
You remember the energy stored in my hourglass, right? That's SP. The instruments on the moon detected an SP energy signature. A big one.
Meaning there's someone in Luxendark other than us who can control SP?
It would appear so. But my hourglass is a guarded treasure of the moon. There shouldn't be anything like it here.
It doesn't have any connection to SP that I know of, but why don't we ask around Florim? It's not far from here.
Good idea. Maybe someone there will know something.
An attack? Impossible!
I must deny that claim. There is nothing impossible in this world.
Aren't we carefree? Well, I'll tell you what else is possible if they hit us again. We'll go down in flames.
Did the blast rouse our little scamp from slumber?
Wouldn't that be peachy? I'll reinforce the seal before we find ourselves in an even stickier situation. What a bother. I suppose we'll have to hide out in the mountains for a while.
Hiding will bring us no closer to our objective. We must unmask the villain who attacked us.
Your Majesty, we're quite near to Florim, land of radiant flowers. As a stronghold of crystallism, I consider it suspect. If your loyal lieutenant might beg a boon, please entrust the task of investigating it to me.
Indeed. But your request is denied.
Your Majesty!
There is another better suited to the task.
Another? You cannot mean to unleash Geist. I would not question, Your Majesty, but... Is he not too unpredictable? His methods are inhumane. The threat to innocent bystanders.
It is his inhumane talents that will find the one responsible for this. Now is exactly the time to use him. Anna, let Geist take his pick of soldiers and dispatch him to Florum at once.
With pleasure, Your Majesty.
Your Majesty, are you sure this is wise? Knowingly putting innocence in harm's way? Sire, I must repeat myself for good measure.
Your objections are duly noted, Nikolai. I bear full responsibility for any evil. Furthermore, if I sent you to Florum, who would tend to our wounded here? The consummation of our struggle is at hand.
I can listen to Cam Clark read the goddamn phone book and it'd be entertaining. I love that man. Rosalia, huh? I actually don't know any Rosalia songs, but... I don't know. Oh dear. Rabbits. They're Iron Men, and they actually look like Iron Man. It's fine. These are all E-types, so... Or no. Yeah, no. All Iron Man 4 E-types. Oh! Most of the jobs from the first game return. There are a couple exceptions. There's no spell fencer. There's no, no spell fencer, no spirit master, no, salve maker, no, the art book talks about this, I believe. I probably should pick that up in English, because it did actually get released recently, but, the canon explanation is that Victor and Victoria are both canonly dead, Kata is in prison, Sigma, Kint is in hiding, I'm trying to think. I believe those are the only jobs that are gone. Oh yeah, no vampire, because he's also canonically dead. Not Invocator.
I've always wanted to visit Florum. It truly is as radiant as they say.
The job that invocates the alternate summoner, that one's also gone, because he is. Not, I don't think he's dead. His fate is ambiguous. All the jobs that were super overpowered either got nerfed or removed, and the ones that were removed were integrated into other jobs. The Patissier and Catmancer both have, traits of the... God, I cannot remember anything right now. They both have traits of the Salve Maker in terms of creating moves for items. Catmancer is also part vampire. Spellfencer is integrated into Tomahawk. Hawkeye, rather. There are no traits of Arcanist or Spirit Master because those are both ridiculously busted and also very, very niche. But... most of the jobs return. And then there are a handful of new jobs as well. Fencer, Bishop, Catmancer, Patissier.
When was the last time everyone was this stirred up?
Wizard.
Don't slow down now. Come on. Let's get back to staging.
Master of Arms.
Staging for what? You don't think. Let's go find out.
Yeah, the art book gives reasons for everyone, for all the, for what jobs did not return. Oh boy. Oh, jeez. Okay, so, non-elemental magic, benediction for full health. So, the reason why I got wizard before leveling up bishop is because benediction, in particular, is ridiculously busted when combined with spellcrafting. It's like, how about casting spellcraft wall on the enemy so that every time you physically attack them, you get a full heal, or benediction mist combined with white mage's group cast all to get a full heal at the end of every turn. Or benediction on a zombie to instantly kill it. Yeah. It's more than a little bit busted, and it's funny. Also, the magic bottle. This is the only way to cure ghosts, and spoiler alert, there are other ways to inflict ghosts than just patissier. God, we got... Oh, that's a lot of money that I need for these. Oh no. Jesus. I've been grinding for quite a while. Also, the cadet uniform. I think this one is actually Idia's, okay, yeah, I think this is Idia's Bravely Default outfit, and then the other one for Idia was her outfit. I think it was like the same alternate outfit you can get in the first game from the place, the town place thing. God, I remember he's fucking shot recently. I have no idea what happened to me. Palbot! Hey, buddy! And Friendbot updated. So, is there items we need to get? Where are they? This is not here. At least the more time we spend here, the longer we get to listen to this absolute banger. Because... Oh, Revo's soundtrack still holds up.
Right? The Sacred Flower Festival is around this time of year.
The Sacred Flower? You mean there's gonna be another festival?
Damn,
yep.
We are.
Every year, Florum holds a pageant to recognize the most beautiful girl in the nation. All the girls who think they deserve that title enter, but only one can win. First goldfish scooping, now a beauty contest? Life in Luxandark is so exciting!
Idiot, don't give Magnolia the wrong idea. The sacred flower festival is a religious tradition. The people of Florum choose a pure maiden to pray for good harvest that year. Though at some point, looks did seem to become the deciding factor.
If I might interrupt, you're wrong about that. It's true that things did get a bit superficial, but everything changed 2 years ago. Now we're really looking for inner beauty. And that's not all. It may once have been a competition for girls, but we're even letting men compete this year. In addition to choosing a flower maiden, this festival will have a bloom groom too.
A bloom groom? So that explains it. I thought there were a lot more men around than usual.
You hear that, you? Boys can enter too. How about it?
Me? No, thank you. I'm no good at being in the spotlight.
I think it's a fantastic idea, you. You're sure to win.
I wouldn't stand a chance. Tiz, on the other hand. He has the inner qualities they want, plus rugged good looks to boot. He'd be a shoo-in.
That's a little gay there.
Come on, you. Now you're making me blush. Besides, you won't catch me up there in some skimpy outfit.
What about a skimpy outfit?
Oh, no.
Well, when it was a contest for girls, most of them wore outfits that showed off their, physical assets? It sounds like things have changed, but I figure the entrants still dress racy. I see. I definitely should sit this one out.
Don't write yourself off so quickly. The competition is open to all who are interested. No pre-registration required.
At any rate, I guess the people here didn't have anything to do with the attack on the Skyhold. Let's at least check with the Matriarch. She's in charge here, so if anyone knows what's going on, it'll be her. Her residence should be just over there.
Let's get sexy is a line that will never die, in my opinion. Or no, it's a, we're going sexy. Phoenix down.
Lady Matriarch, it's a pleasure to see you again.
Master Tiz and Miss
That's fair.
Maria, welcome back to Florum. How might I be of assistance to you today?
We were wondering if you had any idea who attacked that flying fortress.
I fear I do not. Many saw that light arcing through the heavens, but we have no idea where it came from.
Darn. I guess we ought to fill you in on the situation while we're here. That flying fortress is called the Skyhold, and it's under the control of this Kaiser Yahoo, who also kidnapped Agnes. And now it looks like his next target is the Water Crystal.
A troubling turn of events, indeed. We must take swift action. We shall invoke a shield around the crystal at once. Sylvie, come here, child. This is our Vesteling, Sylvie. Once her shield protects the crystal, it will be beyond the reach of any human hand.
In that case, Sylvie, how would you like to come along to the Temple of Water with us?
Wait, there was an item in there. I don't know why I care so much. I haven't been getting them. I haven't been getting them in other places, I don't think. At least not until I restarted this, basically. But, let's see here. Is it behind her chair? There we go. Do 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 down to the water crystal we go. Oh, I so appreciate them not bringing back the convoluted broken temples from the original game. It's so appreciative just to be able to walk in here.
So this is the water crystal. And this is how it's supposed to be glowing?
Why is her hair like that?
Probably. I don't get a stinging sensation from this light. Sylvie, can we ask you to shield the crystal?
Way to go!
Now we can breathe easier. Thank you for helping us, Sylvie.
Yeah, thanks, Sylvie. Now, why don't we get you back to the Matriarch?
I do appreciate the, It's a little less strong in second, because despite using the same music, the temples are, you know, fixed. But I do appreciate the, like, the mood of the temples. The music. It's all set up very nicely, I think. Oh dear. That was annoying. That was less annoying. Back in the city. Bum ba bum ba bum. Doo doo. What a short period to do a view a party chat. And what a strange thing to talk about around a small child. I should be able to observe the plot before stopping, because this is a great bit of plot to watch.
I'm most relieved to see you all back with us. Oh. You must have been nervous. Thank you, Sylvie. You did very well.
Sylvie was great. The water crystal is safe and sound thanks to her.
Comforting news indeed. We can all feel secure now. Tonight is the very evening of our annual Sacred Flower Festival. If you are able, won't you join us for the festivities? Marie, I wouldn't miss it for the world.
It'll be good to relax just a bit. Let's see what all the excitement is about.
Mimic, you might want to pay attention for this next bit of plot.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the moment.
No spoilers, but I think you'll enjoy it.
Let the 48th Sacred Flower Festival.
handsome men and lovely ladies.
I wouldn't have stood a chance.
Even if it's all about inner beauty now, it doesn't change the fact that the contestants are all real lookers. You sure dodged a bullet there, huh, Tiz?
Oh, and after I went through all the trouble of finding this revealing outfit.
Oh, no. Oh!
That outfit is exactly why I refused. Look, it's about
it's the free-
How does one compete for inner beauty anyway? I guess they'll each go up on stage and try to express their best qualities.
Posting about what a good person you are sounds kind of counterproductive.
It's the fucking Waku Warrior.
And now, it's time for our contestants to tell us all just what makes them so wonderful. First up, we have entry number one, Miss Furtive. How great are you?
Well, I'm not just like totally hot. I also do like volunteer work and stuff. And I totally like love animals.
You know, that was not what I was thinking when I said Mimic would love this, but that also helps.
Did you just hear a scream? I did. It sounded like it came from the city gates.
And it didn't sound good. We should check it out.
Spit it out, woman. Who attacked the Skyhold?
I don't know.
Confess, or suffer the consequences.
Leave her alone!
Wait! You're,
It's Eugenie Olcha! In that case, kill them all!
My repeat is still on, but honestly, this will probably be enough. Or maybe not. It's fine. We're all good. Struggle music is still on, so it's a little concerning.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Don't worry. Just doing our job.
But it looks like we're not done yet.
Leave me alone! Help! Somebody help!
Blast it! They're all over the city!
This could get ugly real quick. We gotta alert everyone. I'll head to the stage. You guys hold things together here. Roger that.
We'll meet up when we're done here. Idiot, be careful.
And last but not least, our final contestant. Entry number 8, Alphonse.
Ah, I'll open the way! Tap that seat again.
Behold, even with my stunningly good looks, I do not have a conceited bone in my body. I treat even the riffraff of society with dignity, and am the epitome of gentlemanly largesse.
Okay, Lorenz.
This year's contestants are fine in the looks department, but when it comes to inner beauty... Shoot. Just as I thought. No one's noticed the city is under attack.
What's this? Do we have a last minute entry here?
My lovely lass, while I appreciate your gumption, I'm afraid it is still my turn to...
I ain't here to compete. Move it!
Safety? There will be no safety, Idiali.
Who the? Another of the Kaiser's minions?
Oh, shit. Not again!
I am Geist. Geist the Bloody. I will ask. The Skyhold. Who led the attack?
These people don't know anything!
Preposterous. But have it your way.
Perhaps their corpses will be more talkative.
You monster!
Oh. Did I kill them? Do forgive me. Undo.
Huh? Wasn't I just cut down to size? My wound, it's gone.
Behold my power. The power to make anything that happens unhappen.
So you saved us?
Saved you? Oh, yes. I'll save you over and over.
I'll save over your own death.
I might be hurting you all the more. I cut you down and bring you back. And cut you down and bring you back over and over and over again. Your wounds may disappear, but the horror and pain will remain.
I joked earlier about Yuritsa, but I think this guy is really him.
Perhaps I will show you mercy. We do hope that someone here knows who attacked us. For if not, I will make it as if every last one of you never happened.
No, please. I'm too handsome to die.
I think not. Block all the roads. No one leaves the city until we have answers.
Yes, sir.
Like little rats in a trap, you will not be escaping my realm of torture.
You sadistic freak! The people of Florum had nothing to do with the attack. Take this!
Oh, the girl has some bite, but it means nothing. Undo!
What?
Do your worst. Every blow will be undone. You have no chance of victory. No hope for escape.
Oh my god.
Your friends are busy playing with my soldiers. No one
Feral
will
Sigurd.
Come to help you. You can only sit and submit to my Inquisition. Just like the good people of Florum.
Stop it! They really don't know anything. Can't you just leave them alone?
As you wish. Then we shall begin with you. Perhaps I will lop off your ears first, and next your fingers. Then your limbs, one by one. But I'll leave you your eyes and your tongue. It would be a shame if you could not look on your body in pieces and cry your secrets to me with your dying breaths.
Step no closer.
And this is why I said Mimic should pay attention.
Who do you think you are?
Alternus! What are you doing here?
Whenever you are in peril, there I will be.
are in my way. Time that you disappear.
Ultimus, are you all right?
Never better. Lay a strike. The more pain I suffer, the more powerful I become.
Impressive.
My blade knows no mercy. My wounds become yours. This is the way of the Dark Knight. Gladly I give my own life to vanquish my foe. Care to wager on which comes first? Me running out of life to give, or you falling to my blade?
We may be made to clash, you and I. Your proposition amuses me, but I have had enough amusement for today. We will meet again. I suggest you say farewell to your loved ones before we do.
Thank you, Ultimus. You saved me again.
And that is all that matters to me, Idia. I would come running from the farthest corner of Luxendark if only you called my name.
Ultimus.
Oh, what a power couple!
The girl who risked her own life to save our city, and the dashing knight who came to her rescue.
Why, they're our saviors! Who better to be our flower maiden than Bloom Groom? No doubt about the inner beauty of these two selfless souls. What? Wait, you got it all wrong.
A power couple, they say?
Without further ado, let us resume the festivities. Our final contenders are these two last-minute entrants, Idia and Ultimus. Let's hear some noise from all of you who think they deserve to be this year's Flower Maiden and Bloom Groom. Looks like we have a runaway winner. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you your Flower Maiden and Bloom Groom, Idia and Alternus. Let's give them another round of applause. Wouldn't you all like to know a little more about our new winners? I know I would. Tell us, how does it feel to be voted the finest couple in Florum?
None too bad. It seems that even with my helmet donned, I cannot hide my memory jars.
Cool your jets there, Buckethead.
Yes, well, this year's contest does place an emphasis on inner beauty over mere good looks. And the beauty within you two has clearly charmed our audience today.
I have every confidence that Idia would have been chosen even if the contest was still won of Lux alone.
Ah, can it, Alternus?
Whoa, what's going on here? Sir Alternus, what are you doing here?
You guys, can you believe this? They chose us to be their flower couple or whatever. Us! Vimal? How wonderful!
Oh, mighty friends of the Flower Maiden and her Bloom Groom, we'd love to hear your impressions as well.
I'm not quite sure what's going on, but good job, Idia. Yeah, way to go, you two.
Sit on a cryo, love. A fellow she stashed one. I don't quite follow.
No, no. All I meant was... You're just mum fake. Truly a couple for the ages.
Oh, elle a bien dit incroyable.
Who is this girl? And why does she speak our tongue?
So that was a good bit of plot, and I'm not gonna spell it out for you, but Altanus's reaction to being donned Boongroom, combined with the Altanus Wino's opinions of Florum, you could probably put two and two together about the truth of the situation. Anyways, my controller crapped out again, so it's been about 3 hours anyways, so I'm going to call it for now, but thank you for coming out. Thank you for watching and being here. Good night. Be back at this later. Hopefully my controller will stop crapping out sometime soon. Goodbye.